Our annual Black Friday sale kicked off a week ago with a quick video that describes some of the items included, I showed you the freebie that we're offering, and I talked a little bit about the various savings. Today I have a brand new product to show you, one that we're debuting at Black Friday pricing, with 35% off. Released over the summer, Posca Colored Pencils are oil-based, soft, blendable, and light-resistant. In today's video, I'll show you a little bit about them and ways to work with them. Artist quality colored pencils, which is what these are an art investment that you'll use for a long time. The normal retail for the set of 36 colors is $84.99, but once the 35% off discount is applied, your cost is $55.25. We have a limited number of these sets available, and when they're gone, that'll be it. These are oil-based for softer, smoother lines and easier blending. They're also light-resistant, which I think is important if you're creating art to be displayed. They'll smudge a bit so you can soften hard edges, but what's even better is how they can be blended with something like mineral oil, and we'll get to that in a minute. I don't want to get too far ahead of myself. So, 36 colors here are two trays worth, and here is the first tray in the set, and I went ahead and I swatched them, although I only did swatch this first tray. Now, the first color in this tray is white, so there's not a lot of point in swatching a white pencil on white, so I didn't. But you can see this is one of our 4x6 watercolor index cards. This is the smoother side of the paper, and you can see texture here. This is a piece of smooth white paper, and there's considerably less texture. So this is a piece of smooth black paper, and on this one, obviously, I did go ahead and swatch the white, and you can see that it looks very much like what you see here, although obviously the black affects the eventual color that you see. So you can smudge these colors a little bit. Let's grab another one of the index cards, and I'm going to come in and I will pick up, well, there's this pretty turquoise color. Let me pick this up. So if I slide this in here and I come in, and if I lay down some color, first of all, this is the smoother of the two sides, you can see that I can in fact smudge it. If I come here on the dimpled side, this is the more textured side, because when watercolor paper is made, this causes, or cold press watercolor paper is made, the felt that's applied to the back that presses this down is what causes this texture. But you can see that if I want to come in here, I can smudge it. And what you can also see is that these are soft enough to be blended. So if I grab this green and I lay some of it down, and then I come back and I start to apply the turquoise on top, and I can go back and forth. Now, I'm not a watercolor pencilist by any stretch of the imagination. I'm a mixed media artist like most of you are. But you can see that it's possible to come in and to get a nice blend. And if I want to smudge that a little bit to kind of soften those lines, I can do that too. What I find a much more effective way, though, is a sample of what you see here. So this is one of our Doodle Flower stamps. I think this is Doodle Flower number one. And you can see that I've come in and I've colored one of them, and I've got centers done on a couple of the others. Now, I actually used these two colors, and I believe I used this purple. So these are numbered on the ends. So what I have here, if I can read these, which I cannot because it's kind of light on here. So you'll have to take my word. It's this bright green, which I can't read the number on. This is 39 and the purple is 35. So all I'm going to do is work here, and I'm going to lay the green down kind of in varying patterns, because I want to show you that you can come in and create different looks depending on how that color is laid down. Let's just put a little bit of the turquoise there. I'm going to come in and put some turquoise here. This one I think is going to be, petal is going to be more heavily turquoise. Let's just mess around a little bit. All right, and let me come in now with the purple. So I have some food grade mineral oil. This is what I use in the kitchen to oil my wooden utensils. Let's bring some purple along the side here. And you could use baby oil if that's all you have. If you have any other kind of mineral oil, that will work too. So again, I'm just going to put a couple of drops onto my work surface. And now, of course, I've managed to get oil on my fingers. So way to go, Barbie. All I'm going to do, now there's lots of ways to do this. If you had a blending stump, you could use that. I have a Q-tip handy, so that's what I'm going to do. Now, I don't want to soak this, but what I am going to do is come in. Now, like any color mixing that you do, which is essentially what I'm doing here, if I mix green and purple, I'm going to get something kind of muddy. So I'm going to keep that in mind as I blend, and what I can do is grab the other end of the Q-tip and come up here and blend the purple without dragging it down so much into the green. Honestly, these colors work pretty well together, so I'm not too worried about it. I also don't want to get too much oil on here. So this is the process. It's actually really simple. That's how I did what you see here. I need a little bit more oil. I can grab it. And you can see that I've gone out of the lines. That's the story of my life. I'm always coloring outside the lines. But you can see that even if I drag the purple down into the green, it will change it. Now, what I think is interesting, so this still has oil on it, so I'm not going to come back to that. But what I think is interesting is that I did these yesterday. If I want to come back, and let's say I want to drag the purple down into the side of the petal here, I can do that. I'm just going to grab a clean Q-tip. And all I'm going to do is come in and just reapply to blend this. And it doesn't matter that I did this yesterday. I can come back and refine it today if I want to. So super easy, super simple, and I really like these. I think they're, let's wipe this up before we have an accident. I think that they're nice quality, well, they're more than nice quality, they're artist quality, which is important. You'll find the Posca colored pencils on sale in the pens and markers category of our Black Friday sale. As I said, they're marked down by 35%. If you click show more in the video description, you'll find a link directly to the sets, and I'll also put one there so that you can see all of our Black Friday deals with discounts up to 50% off.